last paper, sir.
Respected chairpersons, deputies, and my friends coming from different corners of the country. Myself is Dr. Salauddin Khan. I am now acting as the principal at a degree college in the state of West Bengal. The paper on which I will make my deliberation is Higher Education in India and the issues of quality concerns. First of all, I will say that to make a good citizen, we need at the same time both elementary education and higher education. It is praiseworthy to ask that elementary education has occupied some space in our country, and because of some novel or good thinking done by Professor Amod Sen, elementary education has been given a specific momentum. Now, with elementary education, we need quality education in higher education. Higher education is on the fast track. It is indeed true, but the quality of higher education is not too much good as we require. That is the main point on which I will try to concentrate my deliberation. First of all, we know that we are producing a large number of graduates as well as master degree holders year after year. But what is the quality? As and when we go through the dissertation paper of the MP students or the PhD paper of the college and university teachers, it is frequently printed in newspapers and in this media that the quality of thesis is deteriorating day after day. So we should be much more concerned on the quality of higher education. The first point on which I will try to focus is the design of syllabus and curricula. That is the most important thing. I think that should be redesigned. The syllabus or the curricula that are taught in colleges and universities throughout India perhaps are not up to the mark, and that does not create any job opportunity to the youths. And because of that, there is some disincentive to the younger generation. So we should look into the matter of job orientation. What the students want, what in which way the students are to be equipped, that should be innovated first of all by the teachers, by the policy makers, by the teachers who are in the responsibility of designing syllabus and curriculum. So the syllabus and curriculum must be redesigned in a scientific way, in a systematic way, so that will become fruitful to the students' community at large. The second factor is the teaching learning process itself. The teaching learning, it is an important aspect of higher education. We know that for making a good citizen, I have already stated that the teacher should be dynamic, he should be responsive, and at the same time, he should be enterprising. And in this situation, I think three D's, that is dedication, determination, and devotion, that must be essential on the part of the teachers and also on the part of the students. The third one is infrastructure and development. It is very essential because the world is going ahead. If the higher institute is not designed with more digitization, then that will not give proper education, although the institutions have a lot of good teachers. So infrastructure and development in the form of making computer lab, in the form of building classroom, etc., other facilities for the students, these must have to be developed within the college or within the university premises. the another important factor, which I think is very essential, is the management. Is the management, leadership, and good governance. This is very vital. Good teachers are there, good non-teaching staffs are there, good laboratory is there, good computer lab is there, but there is a lacking environment in respect of leadership, in respect of governance, in respect of management. And if this is the situation, then it is obvious that the higher institute cannot give the teaching that is assumed to be most effective for the students. And we should encourage the students to give feedback, what they learn from the teachers, what they learn from the colleges. They should give the feedback back. If we analyze the feedback, and on the basis of the feedback, if we try to correct ourselves, then I think that the teaching learning process will become much more effective. Research-oriented activities are lacking in our institutions nowadays. It is, unfortunately, it is a pathetic situation. Recently, we see that the University Grant Commission, UGC, is less interested to give MRP, Minor Research Project, or Major Research Project. I know in our Calcutta Center, Regional Center, for many years, there is no advertisement for selecting the fellows in Minor Research Project. And most probably, it is not seen in the website or in the website of UGC that the Major Research Project, such type of advertisement is not going on. So if the Minor Research Project, the Major Research Project, if another research oriented works done by the Union Council of Social Services, all these projects are lagging behind, all these projects are not coming out, then obviously the research oriented activities of the teachers will fall back. And the most interesting point I will try to point out, that is the establishment of internal complaints committee, ICC, in each and every higher education. It is a must. As per UGC guideline, each and every higher institute must open an internal complaints committee for tackling the situation of sexual harassment at workplace. This is must, but it is unfortunate enough that in most of the higher educational institutes, ICC has not been formed. So it is our responsibility to form ICC, Internal Complaints Committee, to tackle such type of odd situation where teachers are involved, where students are involved in sexual harassment at workplace. And the next thing which is done by ICSSR, the capacity building program, that is, the capacity building program is also important for the improvement in the teaching learning process, because in such capacity building, many types of trainings are provided, many types of research-oriented problems are designed, the problems, how the problem can be solved, how the statistical data can be collected, what are the different methods of collecting data, many things, sampling methods, design, etc., many things are taught there. So capacity building program must have to be introduced. And at the end, I will say that all the stakeholders, that is students, teachers, guardians, local people, all the stakeholders who are associated with the teaching, with the learning of their students in the colleges, in the university, all the stakeholders must have to be integrated for overall development of education, especially qualitative education. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Salauddin, for enlightening us about the various concerns of education in India. You have rightly pointed out the various mechanisms which UGC has pointed out. Your concern for institutionalized ICC in the various institute is of paramount, and I think that's going to be a lead role if the external complaints are sorted out at the institutional level.